गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई एम गौरव गुप्ता एज योर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। टुडे दिस इज आवर थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैथमेटिकली इंडक्शन। आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन, प्लीज लिसन टू मी केयरफुली एंड वॉच दिस वीडियो, बिकॉज दिस वीडियो विल गोइंग टू बी मोर इंटरेस्टिंग, बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू टेक सम मोर टिपिकल एग्जाम्पल बेस्ड ऑन प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैथमेटिकली इंडक्शन। As we already discussed in our first lecture and second lecture, so many questions which are based on mathematical statements either to be equality or inequality. So the question based on equality is very easy to solve, and there is the problem comes in inequality question, and we already did three or four question which is based on inequalities. Now I'm again taking a question which is based on inequality. So keep in mind, you have what's the procedure to solve the principle of mathematical induction, because this is whole chapter is based on reasoning. So you have to increase your thinking power, imagination power, proving power. If you have imagination, then you then the idea comes how we prove such a result. So in this we have to increase our thinking power, reasoning power. So we have to easily do such type of questions. So now I am taking to our next question is P of n, that is our statement 1 square plus 2 square and so on, which is greater than n cube by 3. It means this question is based on inequality. So the first three steps are the same. So whenever you get a question, do all the three steps. Then after we have to find the reason how we prove that. So our first step is put n is equal to 1 and to check the statement either it is valid or not. So let's come on our topic. Put n is equal to 1. Put n is equal to 1. What we will got? We got only 1 square, because I am taking n is equal to 1, it indicates I am taking only one term, and our one term is over first term, which is equal to 1 square, and 1 square is equal to 1. And because in this inequality is given, so we have to take right hand side also. So in this, when I put n is equal to 1, 1 cube divided by 3, 1 square is 1 is greater than 1 by 3. That is true, because 1 is greater than 1 by 3, because in this we have 3 fractions, third parts of 1, so which is true. Now we have to take for an arbitrary value that we have to choose n is equal to k and proceed to our next step. Now put n is equal to k in our equation first. This is your equation first. This is our step 1. And this is our step 2. Now I put n is equal to k. This one is your assumed truth. If this statement is truth, then k plus 1 will be also be truth. So put it here. We get p of k is equal to 1 square plus 2 square up to n. N is your k square is greater than k cube by 3. So please highlight it or put it in a rectangular box, because this is our the main statement that we have to use to prove the third statement. So now I am going to put it in rectangular brackets. Now what we have to prove, this one is our third step. So write them. Step 3, we have to prove, this is our the step that we have to prove. Now we have to put n is equal to k plus 1. Put n is equal to k plus 1, then what we will got? We got p of k plus 1. This one is our first 1 square, 2 square plus up to, here we put k plus 1. because we have to put n is equal to k plus 1. So this is k plus 1 whole square is greater than, here we also put k plus 1, k plus 1 whole cube divided by 3. It means we have to prove this is greater than this term. Then how do we proceed? We have to take the equation second. And what's the procedure to solve such type of inequality? We have to use the equation 2 and change in terms of equation 3 and try to make the equation 2 as according to equation 3. Then what we have to do? We can do either add on both sides, subtract on both sides, multiply, divide on both sides. We have to apply on such operation. And keep in mind, we have to make our second equation in terms of on the third equations. So while we wait, do process. So I'm going to take our equation second. So please make a note first. So I'm going to prove. So I'm start here. We have to prove this, but we have to use equation 2. From equation 2, what it say? 1 square plus 2 square plus up to k square is greater than k cube divided by 3. Now check the third equation. How we can make the equation 2 in terms of equation 3? What are we missing? If we compare our this equation and what we have to prove, third equation. Compare it, 1 square, 2 square, and here this. If this one is your last term, then what will be the term before this term is? We can also write as, if this term is k plus 1, then before that term is only k. Because if this term is 8, then the before the 8, we get 7. It means 8 minus 1. So if we subtract k plus 1 minus 1, we get k. So before this term is k. You can also write here also, this term is your n. So the term before the n square is n minus 1 whole square. We get this. So now compare this. 1 square we get, 2 square we get, k square, but we have not k plus 1 whole square on the left side. Then what we have to do? We have to do add k plus 1 whole square on the both sides so that we can make the equation 2 as equal to the equation 3. So left hand side becomes equal. So we go to our next step, adding k plus 1 on the both side. Adding k plus 1 square on both side. Let's add them. What we will get? 1 square plus 2 square plus up to k square. Now I am adding k plus 1 whole square, it becomes k plus 1 whole square. Greater than symbol is as it is. Here k cube divided by 3 plus k plus 1 whole square. So please make a note first. So I will write here. I am rubbing here. Please make a note first. So let's do our next step. I am writing here. What we will got? We got here 1 square plus 2 square plus up to here we get k square is greater than, sorry, here plus, and now we are solving here. This here is k plus 1 whole square, and we can solve a square plus b square plus 2ab. Now apply this identity. But we will put k square plus 1 plus 2k. Now here also, or you can say that it's easy. Why we are solving? You get this term as it is, because this is our left hand side. K plus 1 whole square is greater than. We have to solve our right hand side. This is your k cube. If we take LCM, I can divide by 1, the LCM will be 3. K क्यूब डिवाइड बाय 3 प्लस के प्लस 1 होल स्क्वायर डिवाइड बाय 1 दो एज इट इज वर्सा एलसीएम इज 3 नाउ वी गेट के क्यूब प्लस 3 इनटू के प्लस 1 होल स्क्वायर डू एज इट इज नाउ सॉल्व दिस k क्यूब प्लस 3 इंटू अप्लाई ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर k स्क्वायर प्लस 1 प्लस 2k डिवाइड बाय 3 अगेन डू k क्यूब प्लस मल्टीप्लाई दिस वी गेट 3 k स्क्वायर प्लस 3 प्लस 6k नाउ वी हैव टू नोट बिकॉज़ वी ऑलरेडी गेट आवर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड दिस इज आवर लेफ्ट हैंड साइड Now we have to take out the terms in terms of this k plus 1 whole cube by 3 because this is we have to prove. So we have to prove in this term. It means we have to find k plus 1 whole cube. But here we are not getting k plus 1 whole cube. So do roughly what's the whole cube of k plus 1? I'm solving here. K plus 1 whole cube. Is equal to k cube a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square apply this a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square 1 square is 1 it means we obtain this if we solve k plus 1 whole cube now Here k cube is we are already get 3k square we already get now we have to get 1 how we get 1 we can write 3 3 as 1 plus 2 so we already get 3k square we can write 3 as 1 plus 2 so we get 1 plus 2 we break 3 as 1 plus 2 Now, the next term is 3k and here is not 3k but we already get 6k and 6k can be written as 3k plus 3k. So, we write here 3k plus 3k and this one is plus. So, I break 3 as 1 plus 2 and 6k as break 3k plus 3. And this four terms it becomes k plus 1 whole cube k plus 1 whole cube and this 3 as it is comes in divide form what's the result remaining we get 3k plus 2 also
3k plus
2 also so again advice firstly we break the 3 as 1 plus 2 and 6k as 3k plus 3 so we get all these 4 terms and these all 4 terms together makes it k plus 1 whole cube and right here k plus 1 whole cube plus me 3k plus me 2 divided by 3 now Please make a note first because I am rubbing this so only you have to keep in mind we have to prove this 1 is equal to k plus 1 whole cube by 3 so please make a note first so I write here what we have to prove 1 square plus whole square plus k square up to k plus 1 whole square is greater than k plus 1 a whole cube by 3 this is our third equation or you can say we have to prove So, I have this portion here, we get this term is as it is and this is greater than, I am writing it again so that you can easily verify
1 square plus 2 square plus up to k square plus k plus 1 whole square
is greater than this. Now, what we have to come, we have to take a term k plus 1 whole cube divided by 3. Is it get? Yes. If we divide them, we get easily this term. So now divide this
1 square plus 2 square up to this term as it is. K plus 1 whole square is greater than K plus 1 whole cube divided by 3 plus 3K plus 2 divided by 3.
We can write as. So now we get our left hand side, and this we have to prove this is greater than K plus 1 whole cube by 3.
I'm considering it as our third equation. And now keep in mind, we are taking a reasoning. What's the reasoning?
Suppose 2 is equal to 2. If I write here, or you can say that here 2 is equal to 2, but if I add here 2 plus 1, then it becomes greater than 2. Again, here 2 is equal to 2, but if I add 1 on one side, then it becomes naturally greater than 2, because it will becomes 3, and 3 is greater than 2. Same here, I am applying the same concept here.
Tell me, K plus 1 whole cube by 3 is equal to K plus 1 whole cube by 3.
Here, both are equal. Now if I add here, 3K plus 2 divided by 3.
K plus 1 whole cube divided by 3 plus 3K plus 2 divided by 3.
If I add this, then naturally it becomes greater than this.
So this becomes greater than K plus 1 whole cube by
3. Are you getting my point? I do the same step, 2 is equal to 2. And again, add 2 plus 1, then becomes 3, and 3 is greater than 2. Firstly, this is equals. And if I add something into that side becomes greater than the other sides. So this side becomes greater than the this side. Now this is your third equation, and this one is your fourth equation. What do you say? This greater than this, and this greater than this. It means A greater than B. Here this term is your A, and this term is your B. And now compare this. This is again B. B is greater than C. A is greater than B, and B is greater than C. It implies A is greater than C. So this term is greater than K plus 1 by whole cube by 3, as we have to prove. So you can write here, from equation 3 and 4 we get the desired result.
From equation 3 and 4 we get the desired result. So statement is true and we
proved. Please make a note first. Now I am going to take another type of question based on principle of mathematical induction. What it say? Please make a read. For every positive integer n, prove that 7 raised to power is n minus 3 raised to power n is divisible by 4. This is your third type of question that will be put in your final exams. Then how we do these questions? The steps are same. And what you have to note, I will reply. So please do your first step. Our step one is put n is equal to 1 and check the validity of a statement.
P of 1 ratio
7 raised to the power 1, because we are putting n is equal to 1,
minus 3 raised to power 1, which is equal to 7 minus 3, which is equal to 4.
And we know 4 is divisible by 4, because if we divide 4 by 4, we get 1. It means it is divisible by 4. That's the statement is true.
4 is divisible by 4. So statement is
true. Now we have to go up to our second step. Put n is equal to k, and we have to assume that statement is also true.
Step 2. Put n is equal to k. This one is our assume true. Put it here. P of k is equal to 7 raised to power k minus 3 raised to power k is divisible by 4. Divisible by 4.
Now you have to stop here, because whenever such type of question you found in final exam, then what you have to do? You have to do your Euclid algorithm. What's the Euclid algorithm say? Please take an example.
Suppose I have divided 7 divided by 2.
It goes to 3. 2 3s are 6.
We get 1.
So according to Euclid, how we write this?
Firstly, we have to write the dividend.
Here dividend is 7,
which is equal to 2 into 3 plus 1.
What is this?
This is, I am writing here, 7 is dividend and 2 is divisor, 3 is quotient, and 1 is your remainder.
So this comes from your Euclid algorithm.
Euclid algorithm.
So the whole concept we have to use here. Now this statement say that this is divisible by 4. It means what is the divisor?
Here divisor is
4. And what we have to divide? That is called dividend. In this we have to divide 7, but in this case we have to divide 7 raised to power k minus 3 raised to power k.
So here dividend is equal to 7 raised to the power k minus 3 raised to the power k.
And then what will be the quotient? But we don't know, because if it this number is divided by 4, what we will get? We don't know. So we have to take as assume.
So let take,
we are taking assume
quotient as n.
But please note, here 7 is not divided by 2. But if our number is divided by 2, then what we will the result?
If I am taking 8 divided by 2, we get 4. 8 cancel out with 0.
It means remainder is 0. So any number which is divisible by any number gives a remainder is 0. So such type of statement is divisible by 4. It means this statement has a remainder 0.
So we write here remainder is equal to
0. So write in terms of this, what we have to write firstly? Dividend. What is dividend? This one.
Again I write dividend is equal to divisor multiply quotient plus remainder.
What is the dividend?
Dividend is how? This 7 raised to the power k minus 3 raised to the power k. which is equal to divisor. What is a divisor? Divisible by 4. And what's the quotient? Which is equal to, let assume m, and the remainder is 0. So we forget this. What we get the result? 7 raised to the power k minus 3 raised to the power k is equal to 4 multiplied by m. And what is m? M is your positive integer greater than 1. Where m is greater than 0. Positive integer. So we have to get the this results. And this results will help to prove our equation what we have to prove. So please make a note first, then I will rub this. So please make a note. This whole step is basically for your understanding purpose. In this we have to use only single statement, that is this statement. So the simplest method is, firstly we have to take the term which we have to divide, which is equal to what we have to divide from. Here we have to divide it by 4, so we take 4 and multiply it m, m is your integer which is greater than 0. You have to write only this statement. This is basically for your understanding purpose. That's why I am rub the whole portion. Please make a note. So let's we proceed to our next step. Step 3. Put n is equal to k plus 1. Step 3. Put n is equal to k plus 1. And to prove it divisible by 4. It means we have to prove this. It is divisible by 4. So put in our statement. P of k plus 1, which is equal to 7 raised to the power k plus 1 minus 3 raised to the power k plus 1. And what type of reasoning you have to use here? So keep in mind and watch carefully and note mind each point. You have to take, in previous question we have to take our second equation and we have to change in second equation to according to third equation. But in this case we have to change in equation third according to equation 2. So in this opposite of type 2 question. So in this we have to change our equation third according to equation second. Then what we have to change? Because if we have to change this equation in terms of this, we have to take separate 7 raised to the power k, its coefficient is 1. But in this case, there is no 7 raised to the power k, but we can make, because here 7 raised to the power k plus 1, we can separate its base. And what we will got? We got 7 raised to the power k into 7 raised to the power 1, because base are same, power will be add. Same here. 3 raised to the power k into 3 raised to the power 1. But we have to separate. The coefficient of 7 raised to the power k is also 1. The coefficient of 3 raised to the power k is also 1. But in this case, the coefficients are 7 and 3, so we can separate. But the separation method is, we have to take common. And the common is, the term is 7, but in this the term is 3. So how we take common? The method is to make, to write in different way. For example, I have 5 rupees. I can write as 2 plus 3, which is equal to also 5. I can also write as 8 minus 3, which is also 5. I can also write 10 minus 5, which is also 5. So same method to change the term according to what you have required common. In this, we have to require 7 as common. So we can write 3 as, what we have to write in terms of 7. 7 minus 4 is equal to 3, so we can write 3 as 7 raised to the power k, which is 7 raised to the power 1 minus 3 raised to the power k, and I am writing here 3 as 7 minus 4. 7 minus 4. Now solve this again. We get
7 raised to the power k into 7 raised to the power 1 negative. If you multiply this 3 raised to the power k into 7, what we will got? We got 3 raised to the power into 7. Now multiply 3 raised to the power k with minus 4, then what we will got? 3 raised to the power k into 4. This one is negative becomes positive. I hope you understand this concept. We have to take common, and the common will be same term. Here the coefficient of 7 raised to the power k is 7, but in this the coefficient of 3 raised to the power is 3, so we have to change 3 in terms of 7. That's why I am right here 3 as 7 minus 4, because the result is same. Now take common 7, because 7 raised to the power 1 means 7. In this we can take 7 as a common. Take common. If we take common 7, then what we will got? We will got 7 raised to the power k minus 3 raised to the power k, and this term will remain same. So write this 3 raised to the power k into 4. Now substitute this value, because this term has equal to 4 into m. So this is our second equation. Put the value from the equation second. Put the value of it from the equation 2. Put 8 values. 7 as it is, multiply this term equal to 4 into m. So I am writing here 4m plus 3 raised to the power k into 4. Now again we can take 4 as also common. So we do take 4 as a common. We take 4 as a common, and what we will got? We got here 7m plus 3 raised to the power k, because 4 we are taking common. Then we will got this result, and clearly this result visible that if we divide by 4, then 4 will be cancelled out with 4. It means this number is divisible by 4. So it shows this is divisible by 4. This is divisible by 4. Hence prove. Because now we have to prove this. Please make a note first. Then we have to take another one example similar to this example. So be ready. Now I am going to take another one example similar to as first. This is our statement. 2 into 7 raised to the power n plus 3 into 5 raised to the power n minus 5 is divisible by 24. So do your first step. Put n is equal to 1 and check the statement. Is it valid or not? Step 1. Put n is equal to 1. 2 into 7 raised to the power 1 plus 3 into 5 raised to the power 1 minus 5, which is equal to 2 into 7, 14, 3 into 5, 15, minus 5, which is equal to 14 plus 10, which is equal to 24, and 24 is divisible by 24. It means statement is true, because 24 is divisible by 24. Now to do next step, choose any arbitrary values of n. I am choosing n is equal to k to put our n is equal to k. Step 2. Assume true. Put n is equal to k. Then what we will got? We got p of k is equal to 2 into 7 raised to the power k plus 3 into 5 raised to the power k minus 5 is divisible by 24, which is assume true, because we have to take it as assume true. So how we can write it as? This is our dividend. So it means
it implies 2 into 7 raised to the power k plus 3 into 5 raised to the power k minus 5. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient. Here divisor is 24 into quotient is m, and the remainder is 0 because it is divisible by 24, and we get the remainder is 0. So where you can write m is greater than 0 positive integers. That's why I am right here. Now we have to use this results. So write in rectangular box because we have to substitute the values. Now apply equation third step, make it equation 2. Step third, to prove true, n is equal to k plus 1. Now substitute this value, we get p of k plus 1 is equal to 2 into 7 raised to the power k plus 1 plus 3 into 5 raised to the power k plus 1 minus 5. Now take same assumption, we have to change third equation according to in terms of second. That's why, so that we can substitute its value. So keep in mind this concept, then it becomes very easy. So make it one by one term as equal to same as equation second. So in this we have to separate its base because here 7 raised to the power k, but in this case 7 raised to the power k plus 1 we can separate by base. So we write as 2 multiply 7 raised to the power k multiply 7 raised to the power 1, and you can ignore 1 because 7 raised to the power 1 is 7. Same here. Here we require 3 to 5 raised to the power k, but here is k plus 1. Do same. 3 into 5 raised to the power k into 5 raised to the power 1 and 1. Ignore. Minus 5. Now make the common, but here is not any term that will be take common. So make it as common. So change that in terms of form. In this, 2 into 7 raised to the power k, this is your terms. And the term is, coefficient of this term is 7. It means we have to change all the terms as a factor of 7. So that's we have to take common. How we write here? Because this term we cannot be changed, because this term we have to require. So 5. 5 can be written as in terms of 7 minus 2. So we can write 2 into 7 raised to the power k into 7 as this plus 3 into 5 raised to the power k into 5 is written as 7 minus 2. The answer will be 5. Now because I am taking 7 as its common, so 7 will come up, we get a terms 3 into 5 raised to the power k. But please remember, here is minus 5. So if we take 5 as 7 minus 2, if we take 5, 7 minus 2, and take 7 as its common, we get only 1, not 5. So keep in mind, if we take 7 as its common, then what will be the remainder? It will be a remainder of 5. And how we write the 5? We can write 5 as minus 35 plus 30, because if we add them, we get minus 5. Please keep in mind, why I am writing 35? Because 35 can be written as 7 into 5. If we take 7 as a common, then the term 5 will be remain at their place. That's why I am writing minus 5 as minus 35 plus 30. There is no other option if we take 7 common. So I am doing here now, do again. 2 multiply 7 raised to the power k multiply 7 plus multiply this. This term multiply with 7, but we will go 3 multiply 5 raised to the power k into 7. Now this term is multiplied by minus 2, then what we will go 3 multiply 5 raised to the power k into 2. Now
how we write 35 as a factor of 7? 7 into 5. So we write 35 as 7 into 5 plus 30 as it is. Because what are terms we have to require? Only these terms. First term, second term and third term. Now take 7 as a common to all these three terms. Then what we will quote? We take 7 as a common. Then we got here 2 into 7 raised to the power k plus take 7 as a common. We got 3 into 5 raised to the power k. If I take 7 as a common, we got 5 minus 5. The remaining terms is this term minus 3 into 5 raised to the power k into 2 plus 30. Please make a note first, then I will rub the upper portion. So what we will quote, I am right here 7 bracket 2 raised to the power 2 into 7 raised to the power k plus 3 into 7 raised to the power 5 raised to the power k minus 5 minus, we can take as a common 3 into 2 which is equal to 6, so we can write as 6 into 5 raised to the power k plus 30. I again repeat, because we are taking 7 as a common, then what will be remains? 2 into 7 raised to the power k, and if we take 7 as a common we get 3 into 5 raised to the power k, and if we take 7 common we get 5. Okay. And the remaining term, this term 3 multiplied 2 is equal to 6 into 5 raised to the power k plus 30 as it is. Now substitute this value from the equation 2. What we get? 7 into this term is equal to 24 into m. So 24 into m. Again, because this value is equal to 24 into m, so we substitute this value as 24 into m. Then what we will quote? If I take 6 in common, then what we will quote? We got 5 raised to the power k minus 6, 5 is 30. 5. Please make a note first. This term, you have to, this type of reasoning you have learned by using practice. What it indicates? Please make a look first. 5 raised to the power k minus 5. When k is greater than 1. If I take k is equal to 2, then what will it be its value? 5 raised to the power 2 minus 5, which is equal to 20. And 20 is, you know, divisible by 4. Please make a note first. So it's clearly visible. Now I am going to take n is k is equal to 3. 5 raised to the power 3 minus 5, which is equal to 120. And 120 is also divisible by 4. So any number divisible by 4 we can write in terms of 4 into a factor. So 5 raised to the power k minus 5, write in the same manner, because this number is divisible by 24, so we write in terms of 24 into m. So this number is divisible by 4. So this is divisible by 4, so we can write as 5 raised to the power k minus 5 is equal to 4 into n, where n is your integer. Here n integers. So we can substitute these values. 5 raised to the power k minus 5 is equal to 4n. Now put this value in here. 24 into m multiplied by 7 minus 6 multiplied, and this has a value of 4 into n. So put it here, 4 into n. So what we will quote? 7 multiplied 24m minus 6 into 4, 24n. And here this, what we have to get? 24 as a common.
24, if we take common, then what we will go? 7m minus n.
And 24 into 7m minus n, which is divisible by 24.
This is divisible by 24. Hence,
proved. Please make a note. Now I am going to take another example which is similar to as first, but the statement is something different. In the previous case, the statement is there are numbers is divisible by 4, 2 and so on. But here there is some modification. In this, the statement said is a multiple of 3. What it's meaning? The statement is same because the multiple and divisible is same thing. How it is same? I explain this. Firstly, we have to follow, you know, what's a multiple of 3? You know, multiple of 3 means 3 multiplied 1, we get 3. 3 multiplied 2, we get 6. 3 multiplied 3, we get 9. 3 multiplied 3, we get 12. So these are the multiples of 3. So 3, 6, 9. 3, 6, 9, 12. All are multiple of 3. All are multiple of 3. Now what we have to do? We have to do our first step. Put n is equal to 1 and we have to check either this is a multiple of 3 or not. So please try to do at yourself also. Put n is equal to 1 and check the statement. Is this statement is valid or not? Now I am putting it n is equal to 1, p of 1 ratio n is equal to 1, 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 5. It means 1 into 2 into 6, which is equal to 12. And we can write 12 as a multiple of 3. How? 3 multiplied by 4. So it is a multiple of 3. So it is, I am writing here, so it is a multiple of 3. Statement is true. Now we have to follow for the second step. Put n is equal to k and we have to assume that statement is true. Step 2. Put n is equal to k. This one is our assumed true. This is our assumed true. Now put it here. P of k is equal to k into k plus 1 into k plus 5 is a multiple of 3. So here please note 3, 6, 9 all are the multiple of 3. So 3 can be written as 3 into 1. So 6 can be written as 3 into 2. It means if we have to write any number into multiple of this, then the factor comes with any integer that gives the multiple of that number. So this is a multiple of 3. It means we can write same as that we have did in our first question. K into k plus 1 into k plus 5, which is equal to 3 into m. Because 3 can be written as 3 into 1, 6 can be written as 3 into 6, but the factor is 3. Remains same. So we have to write 3 because we have to prove multiple of 3. And this digit will be changed. So 1, 2, 3 bits will be changed and we cannot calculate in advance what's the value of m. So where m is positive integer. Now this we have to take it in a close bracket that we have to use, because this is our very important statement. Now we have to follow our third step. What it is? Put n is equal to k plus 1, and we have to prove this. It is a multiple of 3. So please do put to prove p of k plus 1 is equal to, now we have to put n is equal to k plus 1, then what we will put? K plus 1. Here if we put k plus 1, k plus 1 and this plus 1 also, now put here k plus 1 plus 5, we got k plus 1 into k plus 2 into k plus 6, and we have to prove this. This is a multiple of 3, and now keep in mind we have to change the third equation in terms of second equation. That why we are doing this? Because we have to substitute this as a 3 into a multiple of 3, and we easily prove the result. So we have to change the whole statement according to our statement 2. Then how we will change? Take one by one term of equation 2. In this we have k, but we don't have k. K plus 1, in this we have k plus 1, it means we get first term. Now we have to change second term as well as third term. How we will change? So you have to write, again I repeat, if I have 10 rupees, then I can write it 15 minus 5, which is also 5, 10. If I write 5 plus 5, then it will also be 10. If I write 20 minus 10, then the result is also 10. So similar manner we have to change this according to equation second. So I am writing k plus 1 as it is, because this term is as it is in equation second. Now k plus 2 is not available in this, so we have to forget it and change. Here k plus 2 as it is, here k plus 5, and we can write k plus 6 as k plus 5 plus 1. We can write as k plus 5 plus 1. We can write as, so please make a note first, then I will rub this portion. So we can write this as, since these are terms all are multiplication, so we can multiply any one term with another term. So now multiply this. First we have to multiply this, then we have to multiply by this. What we will got? If we multiply k plus 1 into k plus 5, what we will got? We will got k plus 1 into k plus 5. Now multiply k plus 1 into 1, we get k plus 1. And one term is remains, that is your k plus 2. Now we get two terms, k plus 1 and k plus 5. We have to calculate k. And how we calculate this? If we multiply this, we get easily this term. Now multiply this. If we multiply k by this term, we get k into k plus 1 into k plus 5, and now we have to multiply this k into k, we get k square, k into 1, we get k. Now we have to multiply by 2. Now multiply it, 2 into k plus 1 into k plus 5. Now multiply through this, two into k, 2k, and 2 into 1, 2. So please make a note first. Okay, are you getting my points or not? Now I again revise it. In this we have these terms. What we have to, we split k plus 6 as k plus 5 plus 1, this. Now we have to multiply this. First thing, so we, for simplicity, we can multiply by this. Here k plus 1 as it is, k plus 1 term as it is. Now multiply this, k plus 2 into k plus 5, what we will put? K plus 2 into K plus 5. Now this multiply by 1 also, we get K plus 2. Now we have to separate K. How we can separate? Now I am solving this K plus 1. Now multiply K plus 5 into K. What we will get? We will get K into K plus 5. Now multiply this by 2. We get 2 multiply K plus 5. And this term is K plus 2. Now solve this further. We get K plus 1 K into K plus 5. We cannot change because we have to require this. Solve this, multiply this 2 into K, 2K plus 2 into 5, 10 plus K plus 2. Again further solve, K plus 1 K into K plus 5, 2K plus K which is equal to 3K, and 10 plus 2 which is equal to 12. We can also split K plus 1 K into K plus 5. Here 3 can be take common, 3 into K plus 4. Now multiply K plus 1 to the whole terms, we get K into K plus 1 K plus 5 plus, now this multiply this, we get 3 into K plus 1 into K plus 4. Now substitute from equation second, K into K plus 1 into K plus 5 which is equal to 3 plus 3 into M. Now put it here, 3 into M plus 3 into K plus 1 into K plus 4. Now take 3 as a common, we get M plus K plus 1 K plus 4, and this show 3 multiple, it means this is a multiple of 3. We have to prove this. I hope you like this video. If you want to do some suggestion, please do subscribe my channel and give a comment on my video. Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. So I try to make another video to take some another typical problem based on the PMI. For watching my video, thank you. Don't forget to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes.